Keisha for making this all possible. And I actually had some of those people who said they'd watch me on Zoom show up. One is my brother and one is my best friend from law school. And I can't believe they're both still up at this hour. The plague is just starting to get to me. I think it's starting to finally affect me, my mind. I think I'm starting to get worried. I have that feature on my cell phone where you see what's going on in your neighborhood. And the other day, they said that there was some 84-year-old woman had been missing for 2 days. And, I mean, just, I swear to you, for just an instant, I thought, I wonder if it's me. And then I looked at the picture and it wasn't. And I looked further and she weighs 85 pounds. Nobody weighs 85 pounds. My thighs weigh 85 pounds. And I started thinking, those stupid people. She's not missing. She's still in the house somewhere. She just probably fell into an open drawer. And it's litter box. I mean, I know she's still there. And they quit talking about it. So I'm sure she was one of those places. About 3 weeks ago, I was infested, my kitchen was infested by ants. It was terrible. I mean, just everything was crawling with ants. And it took me about 4 days to kill all those ants, to get rid of them. And now I kind of miss the company. My daughter has done great during this plague. She and her husband have never gotten along so well. Everything, I mean, they just, their lives are perfect. Everything has gone so well. They just, they're so happy, they're contented. And she finally realized it was just Stockholm syndrome. Anyway, people always want to know two things about me. How old is that old woman? You do. Well, as I said, I'm 84 years old, and on a good day, I get dressed. Sometimes completely. On a really good day, the paramedics don't show up. And I am a widow. My husband died after 49 years of marriage.
Oh, wow.
It was the only way he could escape. People used to ask us, what is the secret of being able to stay married so god-awful long? And as you can imagine, there were a couple of reasons. One, you know, you stay together because of the children. Neither one of us wanted custody. And on our honeymoon, our wedding night, we swore we would never go to sleep without first settling an argument. I kept that sucker awake till he said he was sorry. I did a good job. I had all the time in the world. Worst thing about being married to my husband was the snoring. Absolutely incredible. I did not get a decent night's sleep in 49 years. The dogs ran off in 87. And I don't know about you ladies out there who have to spend your lives trying to sleep next to one of those snoring machines, but the only way I could do it was to fantasize about ways to kill him. Now that he's gone and The police have closed the case. I think I can share with you my favorite fantasy that helped me get through the night lying next to that man. I would fantasize about dropping those Kraft miniature marshmallows in his mouth. Time. That sound just got less and less. Finally stopped altogether. God, I love that fantasy. Sometimes after that fantasy, I had to smoke a cigarette. the worst thing. Well, he also had that sleep apnea. You know, it's terrible. That's that disease where you quit breathing for several moments at a time. It was really scary. I'd lie there next to him some nights and I'd think, I wonder if he really is dead this time. I think, you know, I could use a good night's sleep. I'll dial 911 in the morning. What is the 49th anniversary anyway? Does anybody know? I don't think, you know, the 25th was silver and the 40th was ruby. I remember because I didn't get one. And then the 50th would have been gold, but my husband claimed the 49th was petrified wood, but you know how to tend to brag. Both for Play-Doh myself. Just before my husband died, we were talking about the fact that we'd gotten older, and I guess he was trying to be kind. He told me, he said, you know, you wouldn't look so bad for your age if it weren't for all those wrinkles. And I said, sweetheart, these are not wrinkles. These are laugh lines. And he said, don't think I ever noticed your neck laughing. Why he's dead.